Hello everyone, welcome to chemistry class. Today onwards, begin the chapter number 2, chemical bonding. In this chapter, we'll be discussing about what is chemical bond, what it is about, and then we'll discuss the different kinds of bonding that is observed between the elements to form the compound. So let us begin the chapter. First and foremost, that topic that arises here is the cause of chemical bonding. Why actually chemical bonding is required? The answer is straightforward, that is related to stability. So different atoms, as we have already studied the periodic table, different atoms are having different valencies and they are having outermost number of electrons. They may be 1, 2, 8. So this is the magic number 8. Each and every atom wants to complete the octet, that is the outermost shell should have maximum 8 electrons, and each and every atom, whether it is having 1 electron in outermost shell or it is having 7 electrons in outermost shell, it wants that somehow it achieves this octet, that is it should have 8 electrons in the outermost shell. Why is it so? Because if the outermost shell is fully complete or full, it is having an octet, then it will lead to stability. The atom will become stable. There is one exception, that is for the case of helium. It is having 2 electrons, that is called a duplet. This is only one single element which has a duplet. Remaining others are generally having a octet. Hydrogen and helium we can leave, they are exception. Others all are in search of an octet only. They either lose their electrons, gain the electrons, or share the electrons to form the chemical bonding. How it is done, that is what we are studying in this chapter. So the cause for chemical bonding is what? That is to achieve the noble gas configuration, or we can say to become stable. So here it is given, the what is the cause? It is the tendency of the elements to acquire or achieve the nearest noble gas configuration. Nearest noble gas means what? Nearest means what? For example, sodium atom. Sodium atom is having atomic number 11. So 11, if we can break into the electronic configuration, it comes to be 281. Now, atomic number 11 is for sodium. Now, nearest noble gas, which should be? If the noble gas neon and argon are close by to sodium here. One is having atomic number 10, one is having atomic number 18. So which atomic number is close to this? 11 is close to 10 or 18? Obviously it is 10. So it is simple. So that is why what actually will happen there? Sodium will try to lose one electron rather than gaining 7 electrons, because from 11 it can easily become 10 electrons. It, by losing one electron, it can easily have 10 electrons, and then it can have the configuration of 2,8 instead of 2,8,1. Then what will happen? It will behave like a noble gas only, because it will lose the extra electron, and then it will have two shells only. It will behave like the nearest noble gas only. That is the cause for the chemical bonding, that is to achieve the nearest noble gas configuration and thereby become a stable atom. Having been discussed about the cause of chemical combination, that is to achieve stability, now we will see what is a chemical bond, that is the definition for this. So the chemical bond is actually a force of attraction between two atoms to form a molecule. Different atoms, the atoms can be of the same element or they can be of the different elements also. So different atoms are developing a force of attraction to each other, and as a result they come close to each other and form a molecule. The reason is already we have discussed, that is to maintain stability. So that is chemical bonding. This chemical bonding is done in three different methods. Let us see that one by one. First kind of the bonding is actually called as ionic bond or electrovalent bond. In this bonding, it is involved with the transfer of electrons. Transfer can be in two ways. It can be either loss of electrons or it can be gain of electrons. Both things are happening simultaneously. First of all, one of the atoms, for example in this case here it is sodium. So sodium loses one electron. This is the extra electron for this. So it will lose this electron to behave like a noble gas to achieve the nearest noble gas configuration. This lost electron will then be accepted by this another atom, that is chlorine atom. Chlorine is already having 7 electrons in the valence shell, that you can see in the red dots. It needs just one electron more to behave like a noble gas. So this extra electron which was released from the sodium atom is accepted here. As a result, what will happen? Sodium loses one electron, so it forms a cation. Chlorine gains one electron, so it will form anion. As a result, both are having opposite charges. As a result, what happens? There is a bonding that develops there. This is called electrovalent or ionic bonding. So this is the definition, the bond between two ions by the transfer of electrons. The next kind of bonding is called as covalent bond. This covalent bond is formed by the sharing of electron. The transfer of electron is not there. On the contrary, what is happening is electrons are shared equally by both the participating atoms. For example, in this case, two oxygen atoms are sharing a pair of electrons. You can see here, they are sharing a pair of electrons that will lead to stability to both the atoms. Individually, single atom, only one atom of oxygen is having 6 electrons in the outermost shell. Atomic number of oxygen is 8. So if you write the configuration, it will come 2, 6. So outermost, it is having 6 electrons. It need 2 electrons here, in this case, to achieve stability. So here, this pair is shared. So this pair will work for this also to give stability. And on the other side, for another atom also, it will give stability. So that is called as sharing of electrons. That is in the case of covalent bonding. We'll discuss in more details when we'll go to these bondings one by one. Then another kind of bonding, it is a subcategory of covalent bonding only. As we saw earlier in the case of oxygen, the electrons are shared by both the atoms. Here also sharing of electrons is there, but the pair of electrons that is totally coming from single atom. For example, in this case, nitrogen is giving both the electrons for sharing. Normally what is happening, one electron from first atom and second electron from another atom is coming. Both are giving one electron to share, that is equal sharing. But here it is not so. Here the single atom will give both the electrons to share. Another one will just take the benefit only. It will not give any electron to share. It will just take the benefit for bonding only. So this is called as coordinate bonding. Another name is called as dative bonding. It is also called dative bonding. Having been discussed the definitions and the types of different types of chemical bonds, we will now deal with them individually one by one in detail. The first one that is we are going to learn now is electrovalent or ionic bond. In today's class we'll deal with this, and followed by that we'll deal with others in the upcoming classes. So ionic bonding, as the definition said, it is involved with the transfer or the loss or gain of electron. Now the question may arise, which kind of atoms will lose electrons and which one will gain electrons? So if any atom is having 1, 2 or 3 valence electron, if 1, 2 or 3 valence electrons are there, then that atom will lose the electrons. Then we can say which are losing electrons are generally what? They are metals. So the metallic atoms will lose the electrons. On the other side, the non-metals, they are having how many electrons there? That is 5, 6 and 7 valence electrons. They are having these many number of valence electrons. So they will not lose these electrons. This is a big number to lose. Rather, what they will do? They will gain electrons. So if any atom is having 1, 2 and 3 valence electrons, they will lose the electron. If any atom is having 5, 6 or 7 valence electrons, then they will gain electrons. As a result, there is a development of some charge there. What is that charge? It can be positive or negative charge. If a metal atom loses the electron, then positive charge will come and the ion will be called as cation. On the other side, if the non-metal gains the electrons, then it becomes negatively charged and then it is called as an anion. Why this positive and negative charge is coming? The question is, why the positive charge is coming and why the negative charge is coming? The answer is pretty much simple there. For example, sodium atom. Just to explain why this charge positive is coming. Sodium atom is having 11 electrons and 11 protons. Its atomic number is 11. So it is having 11 protons and 11 electrons. If it loses one electron, then one electron is reduced there. But atomic number is still the same, that is 11. So if we compare the proton number and the neutron number, 11 and 11. So net balance is 0 only. 11 proton means positive charge, electron is negative charge. So both positive and negative charge can cancel each other. So net equivalent is nil here. On the other side here, the positive charge is 11, negative is 10. So if we see the difference there, then it will come to be positive 1 plus 1. 11 positive plus 11 and negative charge is minus 10. So the net will come as positive 1. That is why we can say it is having plus 1 charge. On the other side, the another one, chlorine atom for example, it is having 17 protons. That is atomic number 17. So it gains one electron, it will have 18 electron, one electron is extra now. So if we compare 17 with 17, the net is coming to be 0, there is no charge. But in the case of anion, what is happening? One electron is extra. So that is why it is having minus 1 charge, that is called as for anion. So these atoms which are forming positive charged ion, they are called as electropositive element. On the other side, the non-metals, they form the negatively charged ion, they are called as electronegative elements. Generally the electronegative ones are of the group 17. They are the most electronegative, the fluorine family, fluorine being the most electronegative. And the electropositive ones are the metals, for example lithium, sodium, potassium and so on. These are all electropositive ones. So electropositive elements are generally metals, electronegative elements are generally non-metals. Now here the definition is given for electrovalent compound. What are these compounds? The compounds which are forming by the combination of electropositive element and electronegative element. Electropositive having positive charge, electronegative is having negative charge. So opposite charges are attracting to each other. So let us read here. The chemical compound formed as a result of the transfer of electron from an atom to the another atom of another element, that is called as electrovalent or ionic compound. The compounds which are formed by the resulting as a result of the ionic bonding are called as ionic compounds. There is another definition given or important term, that is electrovalency. That is what? It is actually the number of electrons which are lost or gained in the process of bonding. If, for example, in this case only, sodium has lost one electron. That is why plus one charge has come at that, and that electron is gained by this, and there minus one charge has come here. So that is why how many electrons are involved there? Only one electron is involved. Because one electron is involved in this process, the electrovalency will be one. In the case of the magnesium, for example, magnesium will lose two electrons. So if it bonds with chlorine and forms there a compound called as MgCl2. So their electrovalency will be 2, because 2 electrons are lost by magnesium and these 2 electrons are gained by 2 chlorine atoms, one each. So that also structure later on will deal in detail. So that is called as electrovalency, that is the number of electrons that are involved in the process of ionic bonding. Now here the topic that we are going to learn is conditions. Now there are certain conditions for this that are the trends that we have studied in the chapter 1 only. Some conditions for ionic bonding, based on that the ionic bonding can happen fast or slow. First one is ionization potential. If the ionization potential is less energy is required to lose the electron, then easily the electron will be lost. For example, sodium, it is having less ionization energy, and if we compare with another atom, for example if we see for carbon, then carbon will not easily lose electron, it will not form the cation easily. So if the ionization potential is very less, then a cation can be formed easily, and that is good for ionic bonding. So ionic bonding can take place in those atoms which are having low ionization potential. Second thing is, they are related to electron affinity. Only the cation forming ability will not lead to ionic bond. Ionic bond needs positive as well as negative ion. For positive charge, we are seeing ionization potential. For negative charge, we will see high electron affinity. So, electron affinity is what? The ability. It is the energy required to gain the electron. So, that is, if the electron affinity is high, then easily an ion will be formed. And therefore, ionic bonding can take place easily. This is in the case of the halogens. Maximum electron affinity is in the case of halogens. For example, fluorine, chlorine and so on. They can easily gain an electron. So, both the factors we have to take in our consideration when we are talking about ionic bonding. Third important thing is electronegativity difference. Electronegativity difference. Difference means the two participating atoms which are forming ionic bond, their electronegativity difference should be very high. It should not be low. For example, the same example will deal, let us say, sodium and chlorine. Sodium is on the extreme left of the periodic table, that is in group 1. Chlorine is belonging to group 17. So there is a wide gap between these two if we see their position in the periodic table. And if we see the trend of electronegativity as we go on the right side, it is increasing. That means chlorine is more electronegative, very highly electronegative. On the other side, sodium is very less electronegative. So therefore, there will be a very high difference of electronegativity. And therefore, they can easily make an ionic bond. On the other side, if we compare, for example, fluorine and chlorine, though both are very highly electronegative, there will be a very less difference in electronegativity in these cases. So therefore, there are very less chances, almost no chances there for ionic bond between fluorine and chlorine, because the electronegativity of both the atoms, because fluorine is also having very high electronegativity, chlorine is also having the similar electronegativity. So if we take the difference of the values of electronegativity based on the Pauling scale, then the difference will be very less. As a result, we can say ionic bond will not take place in this case. So generally, ionic bond takes, based on this concept only, electronegativity difference only, we can say ionic bond is the bond which easily takes place. It forms between the metal and a non-metal. One of the atom is from the metals, one of the atom is from the non-metals. Like sodium is a metal, chlorine is a non-metal. That is for ionic bonding. These are the three factors you have to take care. One is for cation, that is low ionization potential. Second is for anion, high electron affinity. Third one is based on the bonding. The bonding will take place if the electronegativity difference is very, very high. This point already I have told you, the metals will lose the electrons, non-metals will gain the electrons. Here the same point is given, the bond between the metal and the non-metals are ionic and covalent. Now the question that is arising here, why the ionic compounds are stable, related to the stability of ionic bonds. So the ionic compounds, as they are actually ions, and ions are having charges. So the similar charges, if the similar charged ions are there, they will have a repulsion between them. Similar charge means positive will not attract each other. Similarly with the negative ones, they will repel each other, and the strong force of attraction is developing, that is electrostatic force of attraction between the opposite charges. That is very high force of attraction because of the opposite charges. As a result, the compound that is forming by the electrovalent bonding, it is becoming a stable compound. So stability is linked with the opposite charges and their force of attraction. Here some examples of the compounds are given. Now one by one we will deal with some examples. We will see about sodium chloride, magnesium chloride and calcium oxide, their structures, how the ionic bonding is done in these compounds, that we will see in detail in the upcoming part of this video. So here we are with the structures of some electrovalent ionic compounds, how these ionic compounds are formed. First one we will deal with sodium chloride. So let us start here. First of all, the sodium atom, it is having 11 atomic number, and we can break this into the electronic configuration into the different shells. KLM shells are having 2, 8, 1 electron. So the outermost electron, that is 1 electron, is extra here, and it needs to be removed for attaining the octet. The outermost should be having 8 electrons. So this octet can be complete if the one extra electron from the M shell can be removed, and after the loss of this extra electron, there will be only two shells, that will be K shell and the K and the L shell. So as the equation is showing, one electron, extra electron from the M shell is removed there, and then it is having only two shells, 2 and 8 is written there, that is it is having two shells only, and total 10 electrons are there, one electron is lost there, and 10 electrons are there, so it is behaving like an atom. Sodium cation is behaving like the nearest noble gas. Nearest noble gas which is having 10 electrons is neon, so it will behave like neon gas only. Next one, here a table is given, just for reading, it is nothing important to learn. Just you can compare how the atom, normal atom and cation is behaving differently. The properties are shown, the color is varying. Here you can see the normal atom is poisonous, whereas sodium cation is non-poisonous. Why is it so? The answer comes in the next point itself, because the sodium atom is very much reactive, but it will become inactive because it is not reactive. How it can be poisonous? It will not do anything. So next thing, why it is inactive, from active to inactive, how it has become? Because earlier sodium atom was having outermost shell incomplete, but after losing one electron, its outermost shell has become complete and it is behaving like noble gas. And we all know that noble gases are inactive. That is why sodium cation has also started behaving like the nearest noble gas. Next is, already we know it is neutral, it is positively charged. Neutral means it's a normal atom. In the normal atom, it is having same number of protons and electrons. Sodium is having 11 protons and 11 electrons, but in sodium cation, it is having 11 protons and one electron is lost, so it is having 10 electrons. So that means one proton is extra, that is why it is positively charged. Last one, combined state and independent existence. Normal atom cannot live independently because of that extra electron. It is very reactive. It has to be in combined state, like in sodium chloride. It can form a compound and then it can sustain. In individually, in independent existence, in that it will react only. Normal sodium atom will react only. But when it is in compound form, it will not react. But apart from the normal atom, sodium cation can remain independent also. It is not compulsory for it to form a compound. Next, we will move now to chlorine. After understanding about the sodium atom and its cation, same concept will apply. Just here, what is there is the gain of electron. Normal chlorine atom is having 17 atomic number, so configuration is written there 2 8 7. Three shells are there and the outermost shell is having 7 electrons, so it will gain this one electron that was lost from the sodium atom, and hence it will complete the outermost orbit that is now having 8 electrons. So total is coming to be 18 electrons, and 18 is the atomic number of argon, so it will behave like argon only. What will behave? That is chloride ion, Cl minus ion will behave like the nearest noble gas, that is argon, and hence it will also become stable. Here also similar properties as we saw earlier that are written. So normal chlorine atom is yellowish green color gas, but after becoming like after behaving like a noble gas, it becomes colorless. No reaction, no poison. It is not poisonous also. No smell is coming. It has become inactive. All these things are happening because its outermost shell is complete and it is behaving like a noble gas, and it is independent also. That is for the properties of the normal chlorine atom and the chloride ion. So we have seen how the ions are forming by the loss and the gain of the electron. Now moving ahead, how they both are attracting to each other. Now full process in single diagram we will see. This diagram which we are seeing now, this is called as orbit structure. This orbit structure will show how the ionic bonding is taking place. The orbits are shown here, that is why it is called orbit structure. You can see the outermost shell, from there the electron is released or lost, and it is moving towards the chlorine atom. Chlorine atom is gaining that electron because of the high electron affinity, and sodium is losing the electron because of low ionization energy. So chlorine has accepted that electron. So on losing the electron, you can see there positive charge is coming, and on gaining the electron, that electron it has gained, here negative charge is coming. So opposite charges are there, one is positive, one is negative, and opposite charges attract each other. Because of that, you can see here if attractive force is there, here you can see attractive force is there. This force of attraction is called Coulomb force. So because of this electrostatic force of attraction, what will happen? Both the compounds, both the not compounds, both the ions will attract each other, and as a result ionic compound will form. That is an electrovalent compound will form, and the compound is sodium chloride, that is called NaCl. Apart from the the orbit structure diagram that is shown here, we can also represent this ionic bonding in the method that is known as electron dot symbol. This is important to understand. This can be asked to draw, and definitely more or less the questions are coming from here. So what is an electron dot symbol? Another name for this is Lewis symbol. It is also called Lewis symbol. So in the electron dot symbol, we are showing only the valence electron. We are not showing the other orbits. Like here also another compound is there. You can see the orbits are shown, all the orbits and all the electrons are shown here. But apart from this, in the electron dot symbol, only the outermost shell electrons are shown here. For example, electron dot symbol of hydrogen is shown there. Only one dot is shown. We will draw the symbol, we'll write the symbol, and we'll make the dot. The dot is representing the outermost electron. Hydrogen is having only one electron. Next one you can see here for oxygen. Oxygen atom symbol is O, and it is having total 8 electrons. So configuration is 2-6. So we will show only this 6 electrons in the form of dots. And these dots are made in the form of pairs. And these pairs can be on the four sides, on the top and on the top and bottom, and on the left and right. So like this, I have made 6 dots there. These are representing what? These are representing the valence electron. So after understanding the individual, we will see the compound here. An important compound that is there. Electron dot structure of NaCl is shown there. So sodium, it is having only one valence electron, so we'll make one dot. And then chlorine is having 7 valence electrons, so we will make 7 dots there. 2 on upper side, 2 on the left, on the right side, and 1 on this, and total is 7 now. Total 7 electron. 1 electron is lost by this. Both of these are joining together, and after this, what is happening? Sodium is getting positive charge, or it is getting negative charge. As a result, NaCl is formed. This is the electron dot structure of NaCl. Apart from this orbit structure diagram that is showing all the orbits of the atoms and the compounds, we are having one more method to show or represent ionic bonding. This method is called as electron dot symbol or Lewis symbol. This electron dot symbol you should be knowing. More or less there are questions that are asked. You will be given a compound and you have to draw the electron dot symbol or the Lewis symbol for that ionic compound. So how to draw this? So here also you can see another orbit structure diagram. We will come after this topic. So in this diagram you can see different orbits are shown, and the orbits are showing all the electrons that are present in a particular atom. This is not done in the case of electron dot symbol. Rather than what we are doing, we are showing only the outermost electron. The inner shell electrons we are not showing. Only the valence electrons are shown here. And these valence electrons are shown in another manner, that is in the form of dots. These dots are represented in the form of pair. For example, here we can see hydrogen. So hydrogen, we will write the symbol of that atom. Whichever atoms electron dot symbol we have to draw, we will write that symbol there. After that, we will draw the dots. We will make dots in pairs. Now hydrogen is having only one electron, so no need of pair here. We will only make one dot. So this is the electron dot symbol of hydrogen. Similarly for carbon, for example, carbon is having atomic number 6, and therefore the valence electrons will be 4. We will not make this inner electrons. The inner electrons are not drawn or shown by the dots. So we will make 4 dots there. 2 on one side, 2 on the other side. We will not do like this, like you make 4 dots, one on each side. That will be wrong. That is not the way. You have to draw the dots in pairs. So one pair on one side, one pair on the other side. Like this, you can show. For oxygen, that is here, it is given. So oxygen atomic number is 8. So configuration comes 2-6. Outermost, how many are there? 6 valence electron. 6 valence electron we will make now. So oxygen O is the symbol there. So 2 on one side, 2 on one side, and 2 on the other side. So total 6 dots have been made. So that shows oxygen is having 6 valence electron. Now let us come to the compounds there. One compound that we are going on here is NaCl. So Na is having 1 valence electron. 2-8-1 is the configuration. So 1 is the valence electron. So 1 electron is there, and that also is lost. This electron is accepted by whom? This is accepted by chlorine. Chlorine is having the configuration 2-8-7. 7 valence electrons are there, so we will make 2, total 6 are there, 2 on 3 sides, na? 3 pairs are there, so total 6 electron and 1 on other side, total 7 now. So this extra electron, this extra electron is now gained by this. As a result, what will happen here is, you can see Na plus and Cl minus ions are formed and they join together by the electrostatic force of attraction. They are linked together and form the compound. So this is the electron dot structure of NaCl. Now we have completed the structure of NaCl. We will move to the second compound. Just similar concepts only. MgCl2. MgCl2 magnesium ion is there. Formed from magnesium atom. Magnesium valence electrons are 2 because of the atomic number 12, that is for magnesium. So these 2 electrons are lost and magnesium will become Mg2+. It also has now 10 electrons, so it will behave like what? Like the atom having atomic number 10, that is neon. Similarly, so chlorine already we have done in NaCl also, same thing here. But here you see magnesium is having valency 2. So these 2 valencies have to be adjusted here. The chlorine is having only 1 minus 1 charge, so how plus 2 charges will be balanced there? So these will be balanced by 2 ions of the chlorine atom, that is chloride ions will come here, one each will be balanced by each of the ion. So therefore we have written there 2 Cl, so 2 chlorine atom lose 2 electron, 1 chlorine atom lose 1 electron, so 2 chlorine atoms lose 2 electrons. And therefore, here it is 2Cl minus, that is total negative charge is now minus 2. This plus 2 charge is balanced by this. How it is done? You will see, you will get more clear in this orbit structure diagram. So here you can see magnesium, it is having total 12 electrons. 12 electrons are there. Similarly, chlorine atom, both are having 17 electrons each. Now, magnesium has lost the extra electron. These 2 electrons are lost. 1 electron goes on one each. 1 electron goes for 1 chlorine atom. Another electron goes to the another chlorine atom. As a result, what will happen? Magnesium will get plus 2 charge and chlorine atoms both will get minus 1 charge each. And as a result of these positive and negative charges, there will be a Coulomb force, that is force of attraction will develop and the compound will form. The Lewis dot structure also you can see there, magnesium having 2 valence electrons, so 2 dots are shown, chlorine having 7 valence electrons, so 7 dots are made on both. Now this 1 electron is going towards 1 chlorine atom, another is to the another chlorine atom, as a result the compound is formed there. Similar concept for calcium oxide. This is the last compound we'll see for ionic bonding. Now in the case of calcium here, what is happening? Calcium is having the atomic number 20. It can be broken into the 4 shells. If you are doing the configuration, it comes 2 8 8 2, so outermost 2 electrons are there, they have to be removed. As a result, what will happen? 2 8 8 will come, that is total is coming to be 18, and 18 is the atomic number of argon. So calcium, on becoming a cation, it will behave like argon. Similarly, another thing is oxygen. Oxygen is having atomic number 8, configuration is 2 6, outermost 6 electrons are there, so if outermost 6 electrons are there, it will gain 2 electrons more, it needs 2 more electrons. So 2 electrons will come from where? They will come from the calcium atom. Calcium has lost 2 electrons, these 2 electrons will move to the oxygen anion. Now we'll have a look on the orbit structure diagram. This is here calcium and oxygen. You can see the valence electrons are moving towards the oxygen. As a result, what is happening? Ions are forming and Coulomb force of attraction develops and calcium oxide compound is formed. Here you can see the electron dot structure for calcium oxide. Calcium having 2 valence electrons, you can see 2 dots are shown and the electron pair is being donated, or it is being released towards oxygen atom, and as a result oxygen forms anion. There you can see anion is formed and the accepted pair of electron, it has been shown separately, you can see the dark dots. As a result, the compound is forming Ca2+ and O2-, opposite charges attracting each other with the electrostatic force of attraction. That is all for the electron dot structure. Having been completed the different structure, we will now have a look at a separate category of reaction, that is important reaction, that is generally going on in the transfer of electrons. Whenever ionic compounds are formed, redox reactions are taking place. So what is a redox reaction? It is a combination of reduction as well as oxidation. As the name says, redox is, it can be broken into two parts. One part is reduction, another part is oxidation. That makes up redox reaction. This redox reaction, as I said, oxidation and reduction are involved. What is this actually? This you should have studied in 9th class already. But for your reference, again, for reminding, I'm going through this topic in briefly. I will explain this here. Oxidation is actually what? Oxidation is the loss of electron. Whenever there is any loss of electron, then it is called as oxidation. On the other side, whenever there is gain of electrons, if any atom is gaining electron, then we will say what has happened is actually reduction. So as we have been seeing in the ionic compound, both the things are happening together. There is loss of electron by one atom and also there is gain of electron by another atom. Both things are happening together. So that is why we can say redox reaction is containing both the things, reduction as well as oxidation. Both are happening simultaneously, one after the other. And the electropositive atom, that is the cation, it will undergo what? Oxidation, because it has to lose electrons, and loss of electron is oxidation. Similarly, electronegative atom undergoes reduction, because the electronegative atom has to gain electrons, and reduction is also gain of electrons. This will complete the redox process. Apart from this, oxidation and reduction, two important definitions or terms are used in this, that is oxidizing agent and reducing agent. What is oxidizing agent and reducing agent? That will be we can make clear with the help of this example. This is the equation or the reaction for the formation of sodium chloride. Sodium atom and chlorine atom, both of these join together to form chlorine, sodium chloride. So how it is done? That already in the structure of the ionic compound of NaCl we have seen. With the help of equations, let us see, this is called as half reactions. We are breaking this reaction into smaller steps that are called as half reactions. One reaction will be showing oxidation, another one will be showing reduction, and on combining both, we will write the final equation, that is called as the redox reaction. This kind of reactions are given in the exercise also, so you will have to write different equations in the form of half reactions also. So here you can see the first one, oxidation. In the first step, we will show the loss of electron. In this reaction, which atom is losing electron? It is obviously sodium atom, because it is electropositive, so it will lose electrons. So that loss of electron is shown here. Sodium atom has lost electron. On the other side, the second step shows the reduction. So in this case, electronegative atom, that is chlorine for this example, will lose the electron. Here you can see loss of electron is shown in the second step of the reaction. In the final step, you can see there, we have shown there oxidation of sodium has happened by the loss of electron. Reduction of chlorine has happened by the gain of electron. Now the point we were discussing is oxidizing agent. Now sodium has lost this electron. Sodium loses electron. Now which atom is gaining this is chlorine, because chlorine is gaining this electron. The atom which is gaining the electron is called as the oxidizing agent. It is the oxidizing agent for this, because oxidation will not take place if chlorine is not there. Suppose there is no presence of chlorine there, sodium atom alone cannot do this reaction. Sodium cation is present, where this lost electron will go, no reaction will take place. So for the reaction to complete, there is a compulsory requirement of chloride ion. If it is not present, reaction will not take place. So the atom or the ion should be the proper word, the ion which is accepting the electrons, that is oxidizing agent. On the other side, which one is losing electron is sodium. So sodium, because it is losing electron, it is called as reducing agent. The one which is losing electron is reducing agent. The one which is gaining electron is oxidizing agent. Both things are interrelated to each other. Here, the first equation, first example is complete. I have one more thing is there. Apart from the loss and gain of the electron, oxidation and reduction is also related to the loss, is also related to the transfer of oxygen atom. If there is gain of oxygen atom, Like here, aluminium gains oxygen atom, not electron. It gains oxygen atom, then it is oxidized. Gain of oxygen is called as oxidation. On the other side, Fe2O3 converts to Fe, that means oxygen is lost there. So here it is loss of oxygen. So gain of oxygen is called oxidation, loss of oxygen is called reduction. The one which is gaining now from aluminium, now aluminium is gaining this, it has accepted the, so the one which has accepted oxygen atom, that will become what? It will become the reducing agent. On the other side, from where this oxygen is going, which one is losing the oxygen atom, that is called as the oxidizing agent. These are the concepts. You have to go through it once again. This already you are supposed to know, as this is a detailed chapter in class 9th about this. That is all for the part 1 of this chapter, that was about the ionic bonding. We started why the chemical bonding take place. The answer is stability. Then we had a look on the different kind of the chemical bonding. Chemical bonding, that is a force of attraction between different molecules, between different atoms or end molecules. And then we had a detailed discussion today on the ionic bonding. We saw the structures or the orbit structure diagrams and the electron dot or the Lewis symbols for various ionic compound. One more thing I wanted to remind here, this electron dot structure is a better way to represent this, but in exams this are not in your syllabus. Rather, electron dot symbol is generally asked here, as it is given here in the textbook. The orbit structure is not in the syllabus, but electron dot symbols, the Lewis symbols, you should be knowing. Also, you should be knowing this as well, and it is a good way to represent, but in exam it won't be asked. The in-text question, try to solve this in the next class. In the upcoming class, we'll have a discussion on this in-text question, and then we will begin the covalent bonding, how it is done, and the various examples as given in the textbook. We will complete in the upcoming part of the chapter video. This chapter videos I will complete in more or less 4 to 5 videos will be there for this chapter. That is all for today. Thank you.